Hey guys, it's Ben. And for the first time in a long time, I can honestly say, happy fucking Wednesday. Hey guys, it's Ben. What day is it? Tuesday? I'd say happy whatever day it is, but you know what? It's really not fucking happy, okay?
Hey guys, it's Ben.
Hey guys, it's Ben. Happy Tuesday. I'm lying, it's not a happy Tuesday. It's bracing. For those of you who don't know what's been going on, I'm making this video because a month ago I lost one of the closest people in my life to a fucking car accident. And I'm only now just feeling like I'm able to record. I mean, I tried to record.
I've been meaning to record something at some point. I mean, when this all began, you know, when I was putting up my videos on Facebook, I was doing it because I wanted to say something, because something important was going on. Now I'm doing it. I'm doing it just to feel like I actually can. I'm doing it just to prove that I can do something of my own accord.
Show myself like that. Now I'm with a little bit of liquid courage, finally feeling like I can open up and tell you what's been going on. Casey West was one of the most wonderful, amazing, perfect people that I could have had in my life. Like, what you guys don't understand is that before Monaco and Jake and Allie and Rob and all of them, it was the two of us. It was me and her. We didn't really have a big circle of friends, you know? I've known her since I was in high school. I've known her for 5-6 years now.
She always
had a boyfriend. She was always with someone. And I never dated her. It wasn't romantic, but she was my soulmate. Like, you ever just meet someone where you just click with them on such a level, or it's like, wow, I want this person in my life forever. She's gone now. This is my life now. And, you know, I know that I still got my other friend, but about her that she's, it's so hollow. Jake's not doing so great. I've seen what's going on in his DeviantArt, and honestly, I don't think it's the hackers. Like, I've talked to him about it, and it's just, he's... I mean, I don't think he's, like, suicidal or anything, but he's definitely gone off the deep end a little bit. And we all. And that is Monaco. Him and Casey were in the car with Jake. He was driving. Casey's dead. Jake suffered a head injury that caused him to forget what happened. So that leaves Monaco as the only witness. And he says it was wet and he hydroplaned and he smashed into another car. I don't buy it for a second. I'm really starting to have second thoughts about, you know, for so long I tried to convince myself that Monaco was a victim of the hackers and that it wasn't, you know, he wasn't the one doing this. But the more and more evidence is starting to pile up, and the fact that he was the only one who actually knows what happened, he can tell any fucking story he wants. So I'm really kind of starting to believe, maybe, he is behind all this bullshit I've been going through this year. Hell, as far as I know, he might have killed Casey. I don't know how he could have done it, but, you know? It's possible. It really is. At this point, it's possible. I remember back when Mammoth was still in Florida. He was pals with his neighbor was what do you call him? Shaman, I guess? Spiritualist, you know? And he did a reading, he had to go thing, choke it throughout, and it revealed, like, the spirit, the deity that was associated with you, and he did it for Casey and for me, and we were both told that, basically our spirit was, motherly. I don't remember its name, but it was the caring, kind, supportive one that help, you know, it was just, we were mom friends, I guess. It was kind of funny, we got the same thing, but when he did it to Monaco was a trickster. He was the wolf in sheep's clothing. Can you believe that? Because I'm starting to. Better stay the fuck away from me now, though. Because right now, I'm a little sad. But if I see you again, all this anger that I've been feeling is gonna come out full force. But I'm not exactly sad. That's the thing. I'm fucking angry. Doing what I can. So there's this thing, this little fucking dirty old block that keeps popping up everywhere. I freaking find it in the strangest places, like walking around outside the yard. I figured, you know, maybe my roommate's kids moved it or something, but then it shows up in my room, and I throw it outside, and here I am filming, and look, it's right back here. This is exactly what I'm fucking talking about. This kind of shit. Right here. This song is from a very, very good web show called Ruby, made by Rooster Teeth. And this song, when I first heard it, you know, when I first, it's actually the death of a very important female character who sacrificed her life trying to stop bad guys. it was really shocking twist when it happened, and everyone was freaking out and crying and sad. And me, I'm just like, eh, whatever. Now that this has happened, I see so much of her in that character. Every time this damn song comes on, I just... really, it's home now. Now I kind of understand. Now that it's real for me, I know how it hurts to lose someone like that. I didn't mean to marry her or anything. I was perfectly happy with her, you know, pursuing her own romantic relationships. I just... She was like the family I never truly had growing up. I'm actually adopted. My dad's not my real dad. You know, I mean, he's helped me out, and, you know, he's there for me, he is my father, but I never really felt like I was a part of my family. So I made my own. I found my own. And now one of them might be tormenting me. One of them's dead. One of them's crazy. One of them's 2 hours away. So I'm just sitting here suffering by myself. It's not fair. It's not fair, and it was never fair. What's going on? I don't know what's gonna go on, but